Welcome to this presentation on using headings effectively. My name is Greg Krause, University IT Accessibility Coordinator at NC State University. So what are some basic guidelines for using headings within pages? The first thing to remember is that headings are primarily used to aid in navigation, especially for screen reader users. So however you use headings, you want to make sure that they're actually helping the user easily get to the points on the page that they need to get to. So it's important not to use too many headings, otherwise it becomes too cumbersome to actually navigate the page because there's too many headings to figure out what's really important. And it's also important not to use too few headings because then it gets too hard to drill down to the information that they want to get to. Also, don't skip heading levels. Don't think, well, this bit of information is pretty important, so I'll make this a heading level 2, but my next bit of information really isn't important at all, so I'm going to make that a heading level 5. Go ahead and make it a heading level 3 because it shows that it is not as important as the heading level 2. And just a note, the guidelines that I'm going to be showing you here can be slightly different for HTML5, and those issues will be covered in another presentation. So which heading level should you use in your document? Well, first, think of your document, whether it's a Microsoft Word document or a web page, think of it as an outline. You have main points and you have subpoints under those. And if you begin to think of your document in that structure, it's much easier to assign different heading levels to the different parts of your documents. And your most important point of your document should be your heading 1. Now that might be different depending on the type of document that you're making. If it's a word processing document, your heading 1 is probably going to be the title of your document. However, if you're creating a web page, your heading 1 might be where your main unique content begins for each page, not necessarily the title of a page. And there are a couple different ways that you can actually do this, so we'll see some demonstrations of this in a minute. Also, you want to have at least one heading level 1 on a page, but I recommend not using any more than 2 heading level 1s per page. So let's look at some examples of how to use heading levels in different types of documents. So here I have a Microsoft Word document. And what I've done here, I have a title for my document, IT Accessibility Stories, and I've made this my heading 1 for my page. It's basically the title of my document. Now in here I have a number of stories. I have one on creating accessible PDFs from Microsoft Publisher. I made that a heading level 2. It's the next most important point. But since I have other stories, I've made those heading level 2s as well. If I scroll down, I have another story called Google Apps Accessibility Guidelines. Since that's of equal importance as the previous story, I made that another heading 2. Then I have another story, FAQs for ICT Accessibility Regulation. I made that a heading 2 as well. What you don't want to do is you don't want to make your title your heading 1 and then your first story a heading 2, and then come down to your next story and make that a heading 3, and then your next one a heading 4. There's a couple reasons you don't want to do that. First, you're going to run out of heading levels. Typically, you only have up through 6 heading levels, but heading levels also denote order of importance, or how important an item is, and each of these stories or sections is equally important, so I make them all the same level. I make them heading level 2s. And you'll also notice within the first story, so creating accessible PDFs, that's a heading level 2, I have subsections within here. I have a section on alternative text, and since that is a subsection, I made that a heading level 3. Then I have another subsection, I made that a heading level 3 as well. And you can even have subsections of subsections, and you'd make those heading 4s. Here's what this page would look like if I wrote it out as an outline. So here's an example of a web page. On this particular page, what I've done is I've taken the title of my page, the NC State University IT Accessibility Blog, and I made that my heading level 1. That is my page title. In each of my stories, my first story here is getting my Google Doc in a more accessible format. I made that a heading level 2 because that's the next major point. And if I scroll down, I've got another story on Google Apps Accessibility Guidelines. That's a heading level 2. FAQs for ICT Accessibility Regulation, that's a heading level 2, and so forth. And then within my stories, so in my story of getting my Google Doc in a more accessible format, I have a subsection in here, So why make this tool at all? I made that a heading level 3. Now, also on this page, I have other sections of the page besides just the stories. I have little blocks over here on the side for recent posts and categories. Now, I've chosen to make each of those blocks a heading level 2. So recent posts is a heading level 2, categories is a heading level 2, and archives is a heading level 2, and so forth. You don't necessarily have to make these side blocks, in this case, heading level 2s. You could make a case that they're not as important as the stories, that they could be heading level 3s, but in order to keep a consistent navigation and kind of logical structure to the page, I made them all heading 2s. Because by making them a heading 3, that implies there is a heading above them, heading 2, that kind of describes what all of those things do together. If I had some text up here that might say, you know, right-hand sidebar, that could be a heading level 2, and then each of the things under that could be heading level 3s. But since I don't have anything like that, I went ahead and made these heading level 2s. Basically, I didn't want to skip a heading level and imply that if I had made these heading 3s, that the previous heading 2 had something to do with these blocks on the side. In that case, the previous heading level 2 would be the last story listed on this page. And so that might make the user think that these blocks are related to that story, when in fact they're not. And so I've made them of equal importance as the stories. They're all heading level 2s. Here's what this page would look like if I wrote it out as an outline. So here I have a web page where headings are implemented differently. Looking at this page, you might think that the title of the page, NC State University IT Accessibility Resources, is my heading level 1. But in fact, I've actually made that my heading level 2. In my opinion, in this case, this is not the most important thing about this page. For me, the most important thing is what makes this page unique, and it's the content of the page. It's this download Google Doc to Microsoft Office bookmarklet. That is what I made my heading level 1. Within this site, I have several pages that have the same look and feel to them. And when a user comes to each of my pages, I don't want them to think that the main point of the page is this title up here. I want them to know that the main point of the page is what's unique down here. So that's why I turned this item, the Download Google Doc, into my heading level 1. Now you're going to find lots of different opinions on whether this is correct or not. Some people will say you should always make your title of your page a heading level 1. Some people will say you should make your title a heading level 1 and the beginning of your main content a heading level 1. And some people will say, like I did in this particular instance, just make the beginning of your main content a heading level 1. At the end of the day, if you do any of those three options, it's going to be okay. As long as you're using headings effectively and consistently across your site, any of those three options will work fine. In this particular case, since I made the Download Google Doc text my heading level 1, the text that follows that, I did make that heading level 2. So what this tool does, what this tool does not do, and so forth, those are all heading level 2s. Here's what this page would look like if I wrote it out as an outline.